92 rated Sergio Aguero. Is he now going to be good enough for the weekend league? Because you've got to admit, who uses Aguero on the game? I don't, really. I don't think that you do, maybe. Let me know in the comment section. But for myself and what I come up against, never see Aguero at all. So if you can, leave a like. We're going to find out if he's actually good enough for the weekend league. And if you are needing game codes or anything game related, head over to g2.com. Use the code FUJI on that site to get a discount on every single order. And let's get into it. Aguero's cheapest bin right now on the market is 1.3 million. Last night, we snapped him up straight away, 1,170,000. Now, obviously, on this account, I'm not looking to make coins. But when I come to sell Aguero, if I make 100,000, it's all good. 10 games, 9 goals, 7 assists. Now, on the RTG, I look for my striker to get a goal to game. This isn't far off. Who knows? The next match, I could score 3 or 4. 7 assists. That's nice. That's showing that Aguero's not all about just scoring goals. He can assist the play and work the chances. High attacking work rates, 4-star, 4-star, 5-for-8. His face stats on his card look great for a 92 overall. Then you look at his in-games. Amazing. 96 attack positioning, 95 finishing. The acceleration is brilliant, so he's going to hit that top speed very quickly. You've got the dribbling stats. His agility team maybe could be a bit better. We'll speak about that in a second. Strength 81. That's always very nice for a striker. And especially with Aguero's height, he's not that tall, but he can hold his own at times. His jumping's fantastic. His stamina a little bit low. Vision. So, yeah, he can... Well, what's his short pass? 86. So, 90 vision, 86 short pass. 89 curves, so he's going to be able to play those balls to any other on-rushing attacker in your team. So he does look like a good playmaker. I wouldn't play him as a cam, but he does look like a good playmaker, a very good finisher. Is he going to be good enough for the weekend league, though? Because no one uses him, and for me, I'd never use him, and there might be a reason, so we're going to go find out. Oxlade-Chamberlain, was it not the other day where we used his centre mid card, and I liked him. He scored a couple of goals for me. His dribbling, his pace, his strength isn't so bad. 72k though for this Path to Glory card. I bought him for the position change, really. I'm going to sell him after I've recorded this video. I think that's a little bit too expensive, but if you can pick the centre mid version up for, what is it, 30, 40,000, that's a good buy. He is solid. Matic, surprisingly, I used him alongside Bakayoko just to try him out. 64 pace, yeah, he is slow. He's scored a ton of goals. In the 10 games I played, 4 goals from that CDM position. His shot just went in. I don't know what his finishing is. 64, nah, that's a lie. You're going to be seeing some awesome goals there. My tactics, I don't think I'm going to really use these when we go back to the RTG. This was just me having fun, trying to tweak a few things and find out if it would work. Like 40 team width, 45 pressure, and 75 speed are the stats that I really change. But enough of that. You've already seen my tactics. We're going to go and jump in some clips, and I'll let you know if Sergio Aguero is worth the coins. So I have used the non-inform Aguero card before, and the difference between that to the 92, I find that they've really tried to focus on the passing and physical upgrades. Not to say that they haven't upped the whole card, but looking at his vision from 83 to 90, his strength and stamina on the non-inform was 74, that's been up to 81 in both stats. And if I were to be buying Aguero for my team, so I'm going to be putting myself in your position, I would be looking at the physical upgrades. He's only 5-for-8, so if you're giving him 81 strength with a good amount of acceleration, he's going to be tricky. He's going to be able to hold onto the ball for a split second if you've got a defender pushing him in the back. He's going to roll his man, use that acceleration, score goals. Because if you have tried the non-inform, you will know that Aguero is a good finisher. There's something odd with his card, though, and it's the same situation with Kevin De Bruyne. His non-inform was terrible for me. His passing, his shooting even was very inconsistent. He didn't feel that good. Why is it that we have to wait until a team of the year, Kevin De Bruyne, to be able to use him on the game? He is the best midfielder in the Premier League, and his non-inform sucks on the game. Why is that? How are EA calculating these stats? Why doesn't he suit the mechanics? You've got Aguero, right? He's the best striker in the Premier League, I'm just saying. And he doesn't really have a good non-inform card. They've given him 74 stamina, which is, I wouldn't say it's useless, but for a striker, it's not that great. So we have to wait for inform after inform for Aguero to just be playable on the game. And it's not a coincidence that not many people use him in the Premier League. He's only 250,000-300,000 coins. It's not breaking the bank. Why do people not use Aguero? I think it comes down to the way he feels on the ball. His dribbling at times, heavy, clunky. And with the 92, I don't think it's really been improved that much. But again, when you have these stats in shooting, he's going to be able to score. So he only needs half a chance. So if you can see past not having total control over Aguero, because I'll be honest, at times he does feel just heavy to turn. You can drop his shoulder. That's what I'm trying to say. I don't want you to think that you're not going to be able to beat your opponents for skill and to drop your shoulder and get past them, because you will. But when you really break it down and have a look what he's doing compared to other players on the game, he doesn't have that free-flowing movement, which is what I look for in a player. Then you look at the shooting and the acceleration, and that's what makes the card, because 95 finishing, 96 attack positioning, he's creating space for himself, and with that, just creates chances. You don't have to force it into his feet. He's going to be putting himself into a good position and taking up good positions on the pitch, and then if you give him half a chance, he's going to put the ball in the back of the net. There was one goal that I scored, which was surprising. I beat my opponent around the halfway line, and Baye was trying to catch me up, and Aguero was able to keep a nice distance away from Baye. Usually in that situation, they favour the centre-back, but it wasn't to be. And Aguero, with the 93 composure, drilled it across goal, and it's gone in. And the shots that I actually tried out, just driven shots outside the box, they go in. Finesse shots, power strikes. What you want to do with the card in terms of finishing, it's Aguero. He's going to score. But I just don't understand why he feels a bit weird when it comes to dribbling. Why haven't they just made him overpowered? Because I'll be honest with you, if you're not a fan of the non-inform Aguero, I wouldn't bother bringing in the 92, because he still feels just heavy. For me, on the RTG, I wouldn't buy 92 Aguero. If he gets that team of the season, then it's probably going to be the same effect that happened with team of the year Kevin De Bruyne. He's insane. So that's when I would actually use Aguero, once he gets that team of the season card and his agility is up. It's really just the dribbling stats, because right now the strength, the stamina isn't even that bad. That is playable. It's just that the dribbling needs to be added a little bit so he suits the way I want to play. But he might be good for you. That's the thing. If you're looking for a quality finisher, Aguero is your man. And right now, he's selling for about 1.2, 1.3 million coins. He will drop very soon. And I would say a million, maybe 900, a million coins wouldn't be a bad pickup. That's if you're a fan of the non-inform and you know what to expect when it comes to dribbling. So hopefully you've enjoyed today's video. Leave a like, and I'll be seeing you later on today with the pack opening. It's make or break time. We need coins to either get Neymar or Ronaldinho. I'll see you soon. Team out.